Hello everyone and welcome. This is Dawn. I'm back with another video for you. Today I'll be using the Whimsy Stamps Bah Humbug stamp set. It does have a matching die set that can be purchased separately. It's a 4x6 stamp set and there are 14 pieces to this set. So let's get started. First, I'm going to stamp out all the images I want to use using some black Copic Friendly ink. I stamped out two of the square presents and one of the rectangle presents. I'm going to color the images in using my Copic markers. I'm just going to go through the coloring really quick since I'm not doing anything special. I used the B05 process blue to color in the rectangle present. Then I came in with some B14 light blue to go around all the edges of the present. And then came back in with the B05 to blend it all together. For the bow, I use R29 lipstick red to go around the edges of the ribbon. And then I bring in the R27 crimson red to color in the rest of the ribbon. I use the R27 crimson red to color in the Santa hat, and then I blended it with the R29. I use YG03 yellow green to color in one of the square presents, and I color in most of the present with this color, and then I bring in the YG13 chartreuse to go around all the edges, and then I come back in with the YG03 and I just blend it all together. Then I use the R29 again and the R27 to color in the ribbon. For the last square present, I use Y02 canary yellow to color in most of the present, and then I bring in the Y11 pale yellow to color it in, and then I use the same R29 and R27 to color in the ribbon. I used the R27 crimson red to color the broken ornament in. And then I colored over the red with some clear Wink of Stella to give it some sparkle. I also used some of the Wink of Stella on the trim of the Santa hat. And then I colored in all of the ribbon as well with the Wink of Stella pen just so they had some sparkle to it. I colored the pug's ears and face in with the E37 sepia brown. And then I used the E33 sand beige to color in his head and the sides of his face, and then I colored the rest of the body with it as well. I use E35 to do a little shading around the edge of all the body, and then I go back in and I blend it all together with the sand beige. I color the dog's collar in using the R27 crimson red, and I colored the dog tag in using the neutral gray number 0. Now I take a piece of cardstock cut to 3.5 by 8.5, and I'm going to make an ink blended background. I take some distress oxide, chipped sapphire, and my blending brush, and I start at the top of the paper and work my way down the paper. Then I bring in some distress oxide faded jeans and I blend it with the chipped sapphire, and I work my way further down the paper. I don't worry too much about blending it because I'm going to bring in some white pigment ink, and I take the white pigment ink and go over both the colors, and what it does is it lightens up the blue color and kind of blends out any harsh spots that are on the paper. When my background is all blended, I finish off the background by taking some sheer shimmer spray and I spray it generously onto the background. I don't worry if there are any big drops on the paper because I'm actually looking for the big drops. I do recommend doing this in a box though, but I couldn't find my box I usually use, so I just did it on a piece of paper. Then I just set it aside to dry. For the snow hills, I die cut two pieces of white cardstock using the Whimsy Stamps Slimline Envelope Edger Dies. I cut where the curve is on the die, and then the other one I cut out where it makes a mound. I make the mound a little higher than the curve. Then I take my Copic marker, neutral gray number 0, and I make some lines in a downward motion, making the lines kind of wispy looking. And then I take white pigment ink and I blend over the gray Copic marker. This will lighten up the gray marker and it'll just look like some shadowing on the snowy hills. There's a lot of ways to add shadowing, but this is how I chose to do it for this card. Then I spray the snowy hills with the sheer shimmer spray because I wanted it to have the same shimmer effect as the sky background. Then I set that aside to dry, and using the Whimsy Stamps Decorate a Tree die, I cut out three layers of the trees from green cardstock. I cut out the tree trunk from craft cardstock, the garland and the tree topper from gold metallic cardstock, and the ornaments from white cardstock. I glue the tree together, and then I glue the tree trunk at the bottom of the tree. And then I ink blend all around the edges of the Christmas tree to add some shading. I color in the ornaments with R27 Crimson Red. I color the tips of the ornament with my silver metallic jelly roll pen. I glue the tree topper, the garland, and the ornaments onto the tree. Then I assemble the card and I glue the snow banks onto the ink blended background, leaving a spot to slide the tree in. And then I glue the presents where I want them to go. And then I glue the tree on the top of the presents. And then I put the tree behind the snow bank. I adhere the pug to the card and I put his little hat on his head. I use some Wink of Stella on all of the ornaments. I heat emboss the sentiment dashing through the "no" from the Bah Humbug stamp set onto a piece of black cardstock with gold embossing powder, and then I cut it down to size and adhered it to the front of my card. I cut a piece of cardstock to 8 by 9 inches and I scored it at 4 inches, and then I adhered my card front to the card base. Then I trimmed it down a little bit just to have a little small border showing. And to finish off the card, I added some Ranger white enamel accent to look like snow on the Christmas tree. And that completes my card for today. I would love for you to leave a comment below and let me know what you think of the card. And if you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on any upcoming videos and new product releases. Thanks for stopping by and have yourself a wonderful day.